Good afternoon to this, spring day in December. I think the seasons are a little messed up right now, and I want to thank you for, on behalf of the family and friends, and especially Miss Linda, for being here to celebrate Mr. Stacy's life. I've known a lot of Marines in my life, going through basic training, a firefighter, and trained with a lot of Marines. And one thing I learned about Marines in my time in the Air Force was they don't like a lot of fuss. They like it just about the service and about getting to business. So with that, we'll honor Mr. Stacy's life and just get down to business. Let's open up the service in a word of prayer and ask God to just be with us during this time together. Lord God, we love you so much. And thank you, God, that we can meet together under your umbrella to try to do our best here to offer some comfort and some support to the family. And I thank you for what Miss Linda shared with me about Mr. Stacy's life and the fact that he had a relationship with you. And God, with that, we can draw great comfort knowing, as the Bible states, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. We ask you, God, now that the family be comforted in this time of grieving. We ask you, Lord, that friends will lend their ears and shoulders to listen and cry on. And Lord, we ask you that your spirit have liberty to comfort and draw peace in the hearts of Miss Linda and the children, the nieces, the nephews, the grandchildren, so many that are impacted by Mr. Stacy's loss. Lord, we ask you just to be with us in a special way, and that through everything, your name is honored and glorified. As the promise states in the Bible, we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, and to him those who are the called according to his purpose, and we thank you for that promise. Difficult as this may be, God, we ask you through it all, that hearts are comforted and Christ is exalted. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. I was able to sit there and talk with Miss Linda for a little while there at her house, and shared with me some likes that y'all had as a couple. And one that I think struck a chord with me quickly was their love for a gospel group called the Booth Brothers. And that's a tremendous gospel group. And so when asking through music and songs that they like, immediately, without thinking twice about it, Miss Linda said, well, Amazing Grace, of course. Everybody loves Amazing Grace, right? Mm-hmm. And so we found it. If you've never heard it, the Booth Brothers sang a rendition of Amazing Grace. So let's sit here and reflect on this song, and we'll come back and share some thoughts from the Bible.
Saved a wretch like
Amen. What a beautiful song, and I hope that can be a ministry to you. We mentioned this Bible verse in prayer as we were opening the service up, and you know, I can't help but share it because the struggle is on this side of heaven. I'm glad to say, if you've never studied the Bible or read the Bible, that a man or woman that puts their faith in Jesus Christ has a guarantee in the Bible that to be absent from this body, if you know it, is to be present with the Lord. And I can guarantee you that sitting here right now and today in this very moment, that Mr. Charles is there before Christ and doing whatever's going on in heaven right now. I'm sort of jealous, to be honest with you. Would love to join him right now. I'd be okay if the Lord just come on and get us out of this place now. But I want to tell you this, that if you've never accepted Christ to be your Lord and Savior, it's simple. You just believe by faith. This is not just a happenstance message. This is the message of all life, that all men everywhere come to a saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In this time of loss, the Bible says in Romans 8, it says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts, that be the Spirit, knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for, the Bible says, the saints, it says, according to the will of God. If you're here today and you're saved, what I would like to encourage you this way is that you have a great intercessor on your behalf right now, searching your heart during this time of loss, making intercession between you and God to deal with a time of grief. That's the Holy Spirit's job, and praise God for it. Miss Linda, and to the family, I can only imagine there'll be times, I've never been here in this phase of life, where you won't know what to say or even pray. But the Holy Spirit knows. The Holy Spirit knows exactly what you're feeling and takes that before the Lord. And it goes on to say, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to His purpose. You see, in the Holy Spirit's ministry, if you're saved here today, there may be times where you feel peace where you feel like you shouldn't feel peace. And that's the gift of the Holy Spirit, is that He provides for you what you need in a time of need. As a matter of fact, I've mentioned this before, and I felt it fitting here today, that the Holy Spirit will always help us when we're weak. That's His job. The Holy Spirit, as mentioned before, will talk for us when we don't know what to say. The Holy Spirit, much like parents to a child, knows what they need more than you know what you need. And that's part of the Holy Spirit's ministry. And I think it's so important as we transition in this phase of life and maybe try to draw some closure today, although difficult, I think it's important for us to understand that God didn't say all things in life were good. He just said they all work together for good. And that's so important to know, is that we live life. Amen? We live life. And sometimes things get in the way. Miss Linda, I couldn't help but my heart broke for you when you told me how you found your husband. I mean, what a heartbreak. And I can't help but think what a way to find your loved one. That all things are not good, but all things work together for good. Let me paint a picture for you if I can. That sitting there in heaven right now, maybe the Lord calls him Chuck. Maybe the Lord calls him Charles. Maybe the Lord says, get over here, Marine. I don't know. Maybe the Lord says, Mr. Stacy. I don't know. But let me paint you a picture that in heaven, what takes place. I don't know most of you here today, and I count it a privilege that you would even invite me to be part of this service. But who I do know is the Lord. What I know about the Lord is this, is that if all things work together for good, and you're sitting here today without a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, that if you trusted in the Lord today, the Bible gives an account in the book of Luke that rejoicing breaks out in heaven. Here's the scenario. That maybe is before the Lord, as maybe the Lord calls him Chuck. He looks and says, Lord, what's all the commotion? And the Lord looks back and says, somebody just got saved at your funeral service. What a story. That what happens on this side of earth does actually affect heaven. And the Lord is not willing, the Bible says, that any should perish, but that all would come to a saving knowledge, that all would come to repentance. See, God intended heaven for every single person that's ever walked the face of this earth. What I would love for you to understand and take home with you as we talk through this is that God didn't say all things were good. He said all things work together for good. It's God's purpose and it's God's will. The Bible goes on to say that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, the Bible says we will not fear. And that's not a term of just throwing caution to the wind. That's a confidence that, you know what, I'm here to tell you today, as a 43-year-old man from Alabama sitting here smack dab in the middle of Indiana, you know what I know? That God's in control. I didn't make this decision to come here. God did. And so I followed God. What I want you to understand is God's in control of everything. God's in control of every walk of life. And just because God's in charge don't mean it's good, but it will work out for good. That's God's plan. Amen? We're sitting there, and Miss Linda, we're talking about music, and when I asked her about a song, I said, what's some songs y'all like? And she was mentioning some Southern gospel groups that, well, we just connected right away on that. I was pretty excited. I'm a huge Booth Brothers fan. But she said, do you know who Guy Penrod is? Like, how would I not know who Guy Penrod is? You know, if you're a Christian and you've listened to any kind of Christian music, you know who Guy Penrod is. He's the ponytailed good singer, right? That's what I know him as. My son loves some Guy Penrod. And Miss Linda, we were trying to get the lyrics and we were scrambling to figure out the song. And then we found it. And the name of the song by Guy Penrod that we'd love for you to listen to here is Knowing What I Know About Heaven. If you can somehow imagine for a moment that in this song that the man laying here before us that's going on to heaven is singing these words. Let's go ahead and play Guy Penrod.
Amazing grace, and the heavens end.
Amen. Just a moment. I want to give you a moment to share a thought or a testimony that you'd like to share about Mr. Stacy. Maybe it's a favorite memory. Maybe it's something he shared with you. Maybe it's something that you've learned from him. And we'll leave that time up to you and how much you would like to share. Charles E. Chuck Red Stacy, the man with many, many names, didn't he? Of 78, a lifelong resident of Tipton, passed away at home on Wednesday, December 22, 2001. He was born in Leesville, Louisiana, on April 30, 1943, to George Stacy and Maddie Johnson Stacy Head. He married Linda Edwards Roadruck on August 5th, 1977, and were married for 44 years. Chuck retired from Miller's Merry Manor in Tipton, where he was a maintenance supervisor. He also worked at Red Gold, Carnation, and several other places throughout the years. Chuck was a member of the First Baptist Church in Tipton. He was an avid golfer, hunter, loved sports, and especially Notre Dame football. Chuck loved to play bingo and had a nickname for everyone. He served, as you see here, in the United States Marine Corps in Vietnam. He is survived by his wife, Linda, his five children, Teresa Strong and husband, Michael of Tennessee, Diana Black and husband, Randy of Arkansas, Michael Stacy of Indiana, Mary Heffelmeyer, did I get that right? Heffelmeyer and husband Ted of Tipton, Tammy Stacy and husband Carson, Arcadia. Siblings, George Stacy and wife Sally, Susie Stevens, Jeannie Anderson, Tom Stacy, and wife Charlene.
Very good.
Did I get it right?
Yes.
Okay. It was never my strong point. Brenda Misha.
Mash.
I messed up. Pam Johns, Barb Howard, and husband Jeff. Steve Head, and wife Susie. Chuck is also survived by 9 great-grandchildren. Shayla Black, got that right. Callie Heffelmeyer, Kyle Heffelmeyer, Cody Stacy, Matthew Stacy, Colton Mitchell, Bethany Kepley, Nathan Stacy, and Alicia DeLong. 6 great-grandchildren, including his special buddy Zane, along with his little dog, Maggie, and many nieces and nephews. He was preceded in death by his parents and stepfather, Ray Head, mother-in-law, Catherine Edwards, brothers, Miles Stacy, and his wife, Brenda, and Mark Head. At this time, if anybody would like to share a memory or a thought, this will be the time to do it. We'd love to hear from you. Maybe a memory, something that meant something to you. Just anything. This is your time. You can just sit where you're at, or you can stand up, or you can come up here to the podium and share your memory from here. It's up to you. We're not going to force anybody. Anybody.
I know all these brothers have hunting stories.
Yeah. She's got to figure out if they're going to tell the true one or not. That's the thing with a hunting story, you know.
Well, they usually brought the proof home.
They brought the proof home, okay. You want to share something?
Yes.
One of the hunting ones when we were at my brother's up north, my brother-in-law was bragging because he got the first deer, and they was all back at the motel room, and he's running his mouth, and Red picked him up and set him outside, and told him to stay out there until he could shut up, until everybody else got their deer.
That's what I'm talking about. You can't top that story. That's good.
It reminded me of when Fred Flintstone went home and set the cat up.
If he had just said yabba dabba doo, that would have been great. Well, we usually say the best for last, but does anybody else want to, is there somebody that could top that one? That's a good one. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
I'll miss him coming by with his dog, Meg, and showing him his dog Maggie. I'll miss that. So he loved that dog.
Yeah. What kind of dog was Maggie?
A Shih Tzu.
Shih Tzu, okay. Amen.
And she's home mourning.
Yeah. She loved her daddy, didn't she? Yeah. Anybody else want to share a memory?
Golf stories, Tom.
Anybody else? All right, at this time we're going to play our last song before our message here. A song many are familiar with. It's common to many of you. And you just can't beat the message. But it's written by Vince Gill, and it's Go Rest High on That Mountain.
Only you could know.
Amen. The Bible tells us in Revelation chapter 21, in verse number 4, the Bible says, "And God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." You all know this, you're here, and several of you are dealing with it, and have dealt and will deal in the future. But just because there's no tears in heaven don't mean that no tears don't exist on earth. And those tears exist because love was present, a longing was present, and from my understanding, living was present. Tears, from my understanding, in years of living and life and 43 quick years on this earth, I've learned that tears have many causes. Some causes are because of depression, maybe flaws, maybe bitterness, but in a lot of cases, they're a reality of separation. And it's what many of you are shedding tears here today for. But I would like to turn your tear into confidence, if I may. And that is, I know without a shadow of a doubt that Mr. Stacy expressing a faith in Christ that one day I'll get to know him pretty well. We'll call each other by name and see one another before Christ. The Bible says, "For this corruptible must put on incorruption, this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, as the Apostle Paul wrote, death is swallowed up in victory." And he says, "O death, where is thy sting? And O grave, where is the victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law." To be present with the Lord after this life, we have what the Bible calls an incorruptible life. To be present with the Lord after this life, we're promised to be immortal. What a blessing. And that's only possible because Jesus Christ conquered death and the grave. And because he did that, the death and grave have no sting. Paul said to the church of Rome, "For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any of the creatures shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." We have assurance that during and after this life, nothing can separate us from the love of God. I ask Miss Linda, what was your favorite verse? John 14. How can you not like John 14? Some of the greatest three verses in all the Bible where the Lord says, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me." He said, "In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you." The Lord said, "I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will," there's your promise, "come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." God has a promise of preparation to have a mansion in heaven for you. I've got a mansion up there. I'm all right with a shack, but if he's going to make me a mansion, by God, I want to enjoy it. I'm okay just to be there. I'll run the city sweeper. Don't bother me. Happy to be in heaven. But God promised a mansion. There's a promise of God's Word. See, God, the Bible tells us, cannot lie. And God promised, "I got a mansion," and he promised for a return. And in his Word, he said, "I'm coming back to get you." Here's what's awesome about God, folks, and I mean this, and we're going to close here shortly. This is what's awesome about God. That here lies Mr. Stacy in body. As a man that's expressed faith in Christ, His soul and spirit are now seated together in heaven. That's where it's at. And one day when the Lord returns, according to the Bible, God's going to resurrect this physical body. Because the Bible tells us the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then those which are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet Him in the air. So shall we ever be with the Lord. Paul says, comfort one another with these words. Miss Linda, family, friends, here's your comfort. That not a single one of us in here, if you're saved and born again, are saying goodbye. We're only saying to Mr. Stacy, to husband, to dad, to grandpa, whatever his title was to you, we're only saying, see you later. There's your assurance in the Bible. What great comfort we have as believers. The Bible tells us a day with the Lord is 1,000 years, 1,000 years a day. What a thought. To think, what is it now? Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And God's timetable to Mr. Stacy in heaven, to him being in the presence of God, feels like 5,000 years. Wow. That's how good heaven is. And friend, if you've never put your faith and trust in Christ, I beg you, before it's too late, to call on the Lord today to be your Lord and Savior. And then you too can say, see you later. If you never put your faith and trust in Christ, it'll be the greatest decision you'll ever make in your life. Because the benefits literally are out of this world, seated together in heavenly places. We have a few scriptures here that are very common among most people, so I'll cut straight to the chase here. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. I remember, Miss Linda, I remember the first funeral service I ever conducted. I had no idea what I was doing. It scared me to death. I was like, what in heaven's name is this? I didn't know what to do. I don't even know how many I've done now. But this is what I do know. The more funeral services I conduct and the more Bible I read, I am so much more confident than I ever was before. Not at conducting services, but knowing that when a saved person leaves this earth, they are seated together with the Lord. And praise the Lord, one day there'll be a resurrected body. And this man will be, as I say in the preacher world, he'll be three-thirds in heaven. Right now, two-thirds of him are there. One day, the whole package will be there. And what a glorious day that will be. Y'all heard the song, what a day that will be. When my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon His face, the one who saved me by His grace. And when I take Him by the hand, He leads me through the promised land. What a day, a glorious day that will be. What a blessing that is. Let's close this service out in a word of prayer. Dear Lord, I thank You so much for this time we've had together. Thank You, Lord, that we've been able to hopefully offer some closure to the family. I hope, Lord, that today we've offered and honored the life of Mr. Stacy and what he lived for and stood for. I thank You, God, for his family and friends that took time out to be part of this service. Lord, but most of all, we just want to make sure, God, that You had preeminence in all that's been said and done. For this life is all about You, and what we do is all about You. Lord, I thank You for the Christian that's sitting here today, that their life would be renewed in service for Thee these days to come. Lord, I pray for the one that may not know You as Savior, that today may be the day that they trust Christ to be the Lord and Savior. I'm so thankful You died on the cross to pay for our sin. I'm so thankful, God, You gave us eternal life by putting our faith and trust in You. I pray, God, we'll live it out these days to come. Lord, as we close, I pray you provide great comfort for the family, support where it's needed. And again, Lord, as we've asked already and plead with you, that your Spirit would have free course to be a great comfort to the family and friends here in these days, these weeks, and these months to come. And let us not be weary in our responsibility to pray as we ought to pray. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.
This is chapter 2. Out of the ground the Lord formed every beast of the field and fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them, and whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all the cattle and the fowl of the air and every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not a helpmeet. And the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept and took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman and brought her unto man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of a man." The Bible goes on to say, Ecclesiastes chapter 3 in verse number 20, "As God had formed woman out of the side of man, he also formed man from the dust of the ground." Ecclesiastes, the wisest man the Bible says to be on the earth, is Solomon, and he says, "All go unto one place, all are of the dust, and all turn to dust again. Who knoweth the spirit of man that goeth upward, and the spirit of the beast goeth downward to the earth? Wherefore I perceive there is nothing better than that a man should rejoice in his own works, for that in his portion, for who shall bring him to see what shall be after him?" And to conclude with this final verse, Philippians chapter number 4, the Bible says to us, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." And he says, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus." And he says, "Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, and whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, and whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things." I imagine most of the tears that'll be shed will be memories you've made, or memories you have, or maybe things you miss about Mr. Stacy. And those are great memories. Hold on to them. But don't neglect the peace of God that gives you understanding and peace during a time where loss is present. Cling to the peace of God, and I promise you, that peace will pass all understanding. Let's have a word of prayer and conclude the service. Lord God, we love you. As we've mentioned before, we thank you for your goodness. Lord, right now, as you have brought Mr. Stacy to this earth to live the life he lived and made an impact on these many, I dare say, thousands of people through his life, Lord, we thank you for that impact. Lord, now the body that you committed to live on this earth, God, we commit now back to you. Well, from the dust we were formed, and from the dust shall we return. Lord, in the meantime, I pray that we'll cling to the promise of Scripture, that there'll be a soon day where you come and resurrect that body. And Lord, we can draw comfort from these words. Lord, you tell us to sorrow with hope, and there is our great hope. Lord, be with Miss Linda. Be with the entire family. Be with all the friends. It's mourning the loss of Mr. Stacy. And may the days, weeks, and months become easier to bear because of your Holy Spirit and the helping hand of loved ones around. We love you so much. Thank you for this day. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.